triple espresso. That's my ticket. Funny how after I make that order at a coffee shop, the person taking the order almost always asks me, triple espresso? I want to tell the clerk that's not what I said, but actually, that's what espresso means, you know, to express or squeeze the flavor out of the fine coffee grounds. In another sense, espresso also works as a fast or a speed drink. If you want a coffee drink brewed fast without any of the frills, then an espresso is that cup. I listen to customers order pumpkin soy latte or salted caramel mocha with low-fat milk and light on the foam. You get the idea. The sense of espresso as espresso that I like most is the one that first Bezerra and Pavoni espresso machines in 1906 were supposed to accommodate, a 45-second single cup of coffee expressly for you. Whenever I get to visit with my parents, my dad loves to take me to a Starbucks. He's a coffee pot brewed man. He knows I love espresso, however. You can imagine where I go to buy gift cards for my father during the year. I still recall the days when espresso shops were hard to find outside places like San Francisco and Europe. Nowadays, Starbucks are everywhere, populating long stretches of interstates the way old-time Stuckey's shops used to and truck stops still do. In California, Pete's Coffee competes with Starbucks up and down the roads. I know the corporate coffee routine, but when I want an espresso and there's only a Starbucks around, I'm going there. But some of the best espressos have come from independent coffee shops, such as Royal Grounds in Albany, California on Solano. I used to sit out in the morning sipping my espresso while the bay breeze chilled the air. Another independent coffee shop frequented was in Oakland called Coffee with a Beat. I think of my good friends and colleagues, Dave and Karen DeHart, not just because they live in Oakland, but also because this Oakland cafe has a history with jazz musicians. Dave and Karen's son is a musician, and their daughters are artists also. I also think of another colleague and friend, Marty Price. I once saw him on the corner near Coffee with a Beat. He was running down Grand Avenue. If you really want to hear some amazing stories about Oakland, Marty's the guy to listen to. Supposedly, Voltaire said that he drank more than 20 shots a day to keep vigilant against tyrants and imbeciles. His Candide speaks to that. So does his exile from France. As a free thinker, the espresso may have been his best friend. And why not? As espresso, an espresso quickens the neurons, and it's totally about you, the free-thinking individual. If you really want to be free, I say order an espresso.